A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses was tending the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, the priest of Midian. Leading the flock across the desert, he came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There an angel of the Lord appeared to Moses in fire flaming out of a bush. As he looked on, he was surprised to see that the bush, though on fire, was not consumed. So Moses decided, I must go over to look at this remarkable sight and see why the bush is not burned. When the Lord saw him coming over to look at it more closely, God called out to him from the bush, Moses, Moses. He answered, Here I am. God said, Come no nearer. Remove the sandals from your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground. I am the God of your fathers. He continued, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look at God. But the Lord said, I have witnessed the affliction of my people in Egypt, and have heard their cry of complaint against their slave drivers, so I know well what they are suffering. Therefore, I have come down to rescue them from the hands of the Egyptians and lead them out of that land into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey. Moses said to God, But when I go to the Israelites and say to them, The God of your fathers has sent me to you, if they ask me, What is his name? What am I to tell them? God replied, I am who am. Then he added, This is what you shall tell the Israelites. I am sent me to you. God spoke further to Moses. Thus shall you say to the Israelites, The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever. Thus am I to be remembered through all generations. The word of the Lord.
Gospel of the Lord.
The church wants us to reflect on the mercy and goodness of God. In the opening prayer of this Mass, God is referred to as the author of every mercy and of all goodness. And He is the one who shows us what is described as the remedy for sin, that is, fasting, prayer, and almsgiving. What in other words we call Lenten observance. We know that when we live together, we cannot but step on one another's toes. And sometimes we are not even aware of the fact that we have stepped on another's toe. Since for some people it takes only a look to get them off guard. For others, it may take negligence or, let me call it, ignoring one's message or one's action. And people get very angry sometimes because of us, whether we know it or not. And sometimes when we know, it is beyond us to say, I am sorry. Even though sometimes when you say, I am sorry, there is a further question. Are you really sorry? If you are sorry, I want to see it in what you will do next. Are you really sorry? Some people may not be able to say, I am sorry. But from their actions, they indicate that they are sorry for what they have done. Imagine you come back home and your wife tells you, when you say you're hungry, sorry, there is no food for you today. Of course, it's not because there's no food for her to prepare. It is because you stepped on her toe and you will not say, I am sorry. And you come home another day and she invites you to eat, presenting food with a smile. She has not said, I am sorry anyway. But the fact that she is able to present food to you now, after having denied you food, means she has forgiven you. And sometimes, some of us are so proud, we want people to go on their knees before we can know they are sorry. I am sorry is a very short sentence. And it can work miracles, just like thank you. But some of us are too proud to utter that sentence. I am sorry. And I am sorry comes from God's mercy. God's mercy in the sense that God, who is merciful to his sons and daughters, God, who is good to his sons and daughters, expects them to be good to one another, to be merciful to one another. In the first reading of today, Moses, who runs away from Egypt to live with Jethro because he has killed somebody, God calls him out of curiosity because he sees this bush, he sees fire, flames burning, and the bush is non-consumed. So he goes to see what kind of thing is happening. And through his curiosity, God says, Moses, come no nearer. Take off your shoes, because this is holy ground. And of course, God gives Moses a mission to go to Egypt and lead his sons and daughters out of slavery in Egypt. By giving this mission to Moses, God shows mercy to Moses. God forgives Moses for the crime he committed. By leading the people of Israel out of Egypt, God shows them mercy. And he expects them to show mercy to one another. Sometimes we find it very difficult to tolerate one another because we think the way we do it is the best way possible. But there are many other ways to do the same thing. And sometimes others have better ways to do it. But because we are so, call it, short-sighted and also stubborn in our ways, we think my way is the best. In the gospel passage, the caretaker tells the owner of the vineyard, please do not order me to cut down this tree, the fig tree that does not produce. Give it one more year, and also give me time to work on it. Dig around it, put manure, and take care of it. If in the next 1 year it does not produce, then you can cut it down. That is exactly how it is with us. To many of us, others are like a fig tree that does not produce. And we are very quick to say, cut it down. But what if we were that fig tree? Would we say, cut it down? We will not say that, because by cutting it down, they will be getting rid of us. But when it concerns others, we are going to say, cut it down. Get rid of them. They are no use. No. In a human community, there are bound to be differences. But God, who has made us in his own image and likeness, has endowed each and every one of us with the capacity to understand that there is a difference between the wrongdoing of my brother or my sister and my brother or my sister. I may hate what my brother or sister does that is not good to me. But I need to make a distinction between that thing my brother or sister does and my brother or sister. I threw away the thing and embraced my brother or my sister. Women will know this a lot better, especially as mothers. When you bathe your baby, when you wash your baby in the bowl, for example, you take the baby out of the bowl, take care of the baby, and throw away the dirty water. But when you fail to make a distinction between the evil that your brother does and your brother or your sister, sister. It is like a woman who throws away both the baby and the dirty water. That is not what we are called to do. Today, we have the opportunity to celebrate this Mass in the presence of NSOBAhti. NSOBAhti is an association of men and women from Nsob land. I say men and women, but I'm very hesitant to say men and women because I'm only seeing women singing. I'm not seeing the men. The one man I saw came in electionary procession, and there are two other men in the choir who could also be in any other choir because they are technicians. But my interest this morning is in the name NSOBAhti. NSOBAhti is an invitation to bring the Nsob people together so that they may be one. Of course, Nsob is not all Catholic. Nsob land is not all Catholic. We have Catholics, we have Protestants, we have Muslims, and we even have some who do not belong anywhere. And your family is scattered. Yeah. Would you be a member of some party with a scattered family? How can we proclaim peace and unity and live in war and disarmament? So, this is an opportunity for us to say we need to be more and more united. We need to build together. Because that is the way God wants it to be. And even the non-Catholic members of NSOBAhti, you never know, they may become Catholic tomorrow because of the beautiful way the Catholic members of NSOBAhti witnessed their faith. Gambatumi of blessed memory told the story of a lady who attended Holy Week ceremonies in Douala, in the cathedral. And at the end, on Easter Sunday, she came to him and said, "I want to become Catholic." And he asked, "Why?" Said, "The way I have seen things happen here, since Thursday, Sunday, tells me this is the church Christ founded. And that is why I want to become Catholic. If the priests who celebrated did their own things, if the choir that sang, their own thing. If anybody at all did as they wanted, not as the church wants, that woman would never have had the feeling this is the church Christ founded." No. And NSOBAhti, please, you are called to build together. And you must build together for every member of NSOBAhti. There is no great member, there is no small member. All members of NSOBAhti are one. And as such, we are able to live the name NSOBAhti. My dear brothers and sisters, God shows mercy to us now. He wants us to show mercy to one another now.
Okay. as long as we make our prayers to Thee.
Our response is, and be with us always. For the church, may she always be conscious of God's abiding presence in her midst, that He who delivered the Jews from the bondage of slavery will liberate the Church of Christ from the snares of her enemies. Lord, hear us. For the government of our world, may they be true to the Christian principles of the basic dignity of man, who is made in God's image and likeness. Lord, hear us.
And be with us.
For those who are oppressed and suffer hardships, may they be encouraged by the ever-present compassion and love of God, who sees their afflictions and who will deliver them from evil. Lord, hear us.
And be with us always.
For Christians everywhere, especially the community, may we, through prayer and repentance, fix our minds and hearts on God and turn away from those things which destroy our relationship with Him and with one another. Lord, hear us.
And hear us always.
Let us pray for the intentions of this Mass as we read at the beginning. Lord, hear us.
And hear us always.
We pray in silence to God our Father, who is always ready to answer our petitions. Lord, hear us. We make our prayer with Mary, who lives in the presence of God. Hail Mary.
image of peace yet hidden in heaven, and are nourished by sea on earth with the bread that comes from on high. We humbly entreat you, Lord, that what is being brought about in us in ministry may come to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Yeah. You see, beautiful things are not here. I am glad at heart that NSOBAhti accepted to come into this church, take over the 10 a.m. Mass in Toto. And Monsignor Zifirinus, the priest from the Diocese of Kumbu, gave us a very beautiful reflection. That ties with why you decided to meet at all today. Please, unity is strength. And Christ exhorts us to love one another. Don't be divided. We are in the presence of our President General, very well done. Yuri Ecclesia. Thank you all. Thank you for the beautiful singing. Thank you, the general population from Kumo. Thank you, the priestess of Simbock. Thank you, those like Father mentioned, who have come from different churches. God is one. That is why I always begin in the general role when I'm asked to lead prayers. I say, we continue to thank Allah, our God, who is Almighty, who is El Shaddai, who is Ta'an, who is Ta'wimimbom, and who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God bless you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I wish all the nice holidays.
Thank you.